Are you ready to go, Mission Scout? Huh? Hi, buddy. Hi. Are you ready to go? Gosh, you're so cute.
What's going on YouTube, and welcome back to my channel. If you've been here before, thank you for returning. If you are new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on those post notifications so you are notified every single time I drop a video and you don't miss not one video. Everybody in here, smash that like button, share this video, and drop a comment down below during the video, after the video, before the video, whatever you feel. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you like about the video. Let me know what you want to see next. You saw by the title and the thumbnail, we got a good one. So let's get straight into this groom. And also, you guys, make sure you are watching those ads. I know some of them can be a little lengthy, but make sure you're watching as many ads as you can. That helps me to continue to do this as much as I am, and hopefully push me to do this on a more full-time basis. It helps me and it helps support my channel. It helps us to continue to grow and get out there into the algorithm. But let's get straight into the groom. Okay, everybody, this is Scout, and like I said in the title, yes, he is a rare breed. He's not really one that you see often, really ever. He is a Pit Australian Shepherd mix, at least that's what we think, and that's what he looks like. He literally looks like a Pit Australian Shepherd cross straight down the middle. And when I tell you, he is the sweetest dog, he's the most beautiful dog. He has a beautiful coat. He has such a calm demeanor. He is all around just a great dog, and he pretty much just lets me do whatever I need to do except for dry his face. He does not like to dry around his face, which is common. Every dog is pretty much like that, because you have to think about it, you're blowing a high pressure velocity dryer in their face. So I get that completely, but he is one of my favorite clients. He is one of the best clients that I do, because like I said, he's super easy. He just gets a bath and a cleanup. I do his paw pads, do his feet, do his nails, a little bit of a sanding, some light trimming, and he is completely done. So there's not much for me to talk about in this video, so I'm not going to talk much in this video. If y'all have any questions, y'all can drop them down below, but I will pop in when I need to and say what I have to say.
Dog for those. Whoa. What kind were they? Oh. Uh-oh. come, come, brush, brush, brush. Especially with Doodles. $10 off. I'm so mad. I should have waited. I ain't gonna tell my girl because she was like, see, you so eager to get those clippers. I was like, well, the other ones that I had was gonna go out on me at some point in time. Mine? Oh, yes. No, I agree. Yep. Yep. Yep, because I'll be talking to my girlfriend about something, and then I'll be on Facebook, and there's an ad right there for it, and I'm like, it is scary. Oh, God, your nail grind dust is in my mouth. Oh, that was so nasty. I gotta do it. See, that was it. Real quick. No, we don't usually rest around with your little sanitary, but she wanted it done this time. I love her little flower. It's okay, bud. Perfect. He's just a chicken. I get a lot of scary dogs and a lot of bad dogs at PetSmart. So some of the bad dogs that didn't follow me, I was, thank God. Oh, I only let you know out of courtesy.
So I want to pop in right here real quick and just explain why we have towels on the floor, because I believe that was attached to the comment of the salon being messy. And I know I touched on this already, so I'm not going to speak on it too long. So the reason why we have towels on the floor is because we get a lot of dogs, a lot of hairy dogs, that when they have a lot of water on them, they shake And one time we had the water overfill in the tub and flood out onto the floor, and it messed up the floor. So we put towels on the floor to catch the majority of that water, and that's why we put towels down on the floor. So if you see in the video, if I have the camera angle like this, and you see when I'm walking into the bathing area that there are towels on the floor, that is why, because it catches the water, and honestly, it catches a lot of the hair too. So we're catching the water, we're catching the hair, and it keeps our area dry so we're not slipping and falling. Because I know people have questions about us slipping and falling. That is why we have stuff on the floor.
Bless you. You're welcome. Now, do not be that dog that chokes itself one time. Wow, bless you. That was a big one.
tough one.
So I just want to pop in real quick and just tell you what I'm washing him with. I am using the brightening shampoo by Hydra. So it's technically tailored, I think, for white coats, but it smells really good and it gets them pretty decently clean. In my opinion, it's not the best clean that I've ever felt for a shampoo, but it gets them clean enough for me to put the conditioner on next. So the conditioner that I'm going to be doing on him, I think y'all saw it, it's the iGroom de-shedding and detangling conditioner. This conditioner is phenomenal. It's so good. I mean, when I tell you, I feel like it's helped every single shedding dog that I've ever groomed. Like, using the Furminator is one thing because that's what PetSmart offered, but using the iGroom, when I say the second time around Scout coming, so not this video, but the second time he came in, it made such a huge difference on what actually blew out his coat. So in this video, you're going to see some blow out of him, but you're not going to see a whole lot. But the very next time he came in, it made such a huge difference. I was like, wow, I didn't even know he shed that much. And it made his coat so silky and so soft, and it just laid so smooth to his body. It's a really, really good conditioner. So if you guys have dogs that shed a lot and you need a good shampoo and conditioner, the iGroom De-Shed and Detangling shampoo and conditioner, phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal. I recommend everybody to get it. It's 5 stars hands down.
I know, I was wondering what was making that noise. I was like, what she got over there? Oh yeah. Oh god. Yeah. Right. Right. Yeah, right. Yeah, that's why I like to use like rubber curries or even a glove like that, like, because I feel like it scrubs better than just my hand. Come on, Scout. Spin it around. was looking at the hydrants, they have a luxury line. I did not know how much hydrant costs. Oh my God. I did not know that how much they cost.
Thank you.
That's the biggest long-haired dachshund I've ever seen. I think it's mixed too. That dog is huge. I said, oh my God. Great. One thing about conditioner, it takes forever to rinse out. One thing. Say it again. Oh, yeah. I didn't even know they had it mixed in. I did not know. Oh, that's good to know because I've been putting conditioner after it. Yeah, me too. Yeah. That's good to know. Right. You proved that. Yeah, I bet.
I bet that dog weighs less.
Probably. Or they weigh about the same. He's just short. Yeah. Doodles are fun. I love when doodle owners let me do cute haircuts. Like, yeah, let me give your dog longer legs. Come on. Don't get the basic cut. Yeah. Yes. Uh-huh. Really? My Yazzie, she her body is a 4 and her legs are 5/8. I had to take them down because they were a little too long. Yeah. Well, that's good. I'm not that consistent with Yazzie. Yeah. Well, yeah, he was, but I usually brush them out before the bath and then condition them really good. Yep. There you go. Oh, you weren't? You said she does get along with your dogs? That's good. Well, that's good. Really? What other kind of dog do you have? Okay. No. Does your mom baby her? That's why. Uh-huh. Oh, well, yeah. She's like, I ain't about that life, Mom. It is, I think, in here. That. And that just goes straight on. Lather is really nice. Yeah, it pours. Yeah, I thought about that. King Charles, he's an old man. I actually had to bring him in here for a haircut at some point in time. The other one is a Yorkie Poodle. She is my girlfriend's dog, which I have adopted as my dog as well, even though she is a turd. And then the other one is Yazzie, the Shih Tzu Bichon. Well, suppose the Shih Tzu Bichon. I want to do a DNA test for her because I don't believe this hair is. Really? Oh, I'll compare pictures because I don't believe she is one. Yeah. Right. She's not even the same color that she was when she was a puppy. Yeah. Really? Yeah, when she was a puppy, she had black and brown ears. This is when she was 2 months. Yeah, black and brown ears. And then when she turned an adult age, 1 year old, she had gray ears. Like, yeah, gray ears. Everything else was white. Now she's white with a tan patch on her side and tan ears. I'm like, what the heck kind of dog are you? You didn't change 3 different colors. No. Nope. You gotta be over here. Scout, you gotta stand in the... Uh-huh. That's crazy. Nope. pigtail, yeah. I'll show you a picture in a second. I'll show you a picture in a second.
So the reason why I go through his coat with a comb vigorously is because it is to get all the loose hairs out. And I found that this comb actually grabs the most hair than any other comb that I've had. So I absolutely love this comb. It is a Chris Christensen comb. And you can find it on Amazon. I definitely think I put it in my description box. If it's not in there, you let me know. I'll pop it in there for you. But I'm pretty sure it's in there. But I just go through his coat and comb it really good. And then I go through and scissor him.
Promise her because Coco's bad. Yeah. Well, Coco's good for me. She just is as fast for her nails. No other girl has been able to get a hair curl on her though. Yeah, she's an interesting little somebody. So when I left PetSmart, they tried to do her. They were like, oh, we can do her. And then they called the owner and was like, yeah, we can't get a haircut on her. Yeah. Like, I knew they wouldn't be able to. I already knew. I love him. He's so good. He's so good. Right? You're like, whatever. Yes. Know her. That's not her mama. Yeah. Really? He's probably the most relaxed dog I've ever groomed. Gotcha, okay. A little mini dachshund. Oh. Yeah. Are they broken?
No, I got them working.
Okay.
But whoever shot them before, you see how that tip right there, right?
Yeah.
The tip rounds off?
Uh-huh.
It should go straight.
Oh.
And what happens is when they sharpen them, they come out too far and they round that tip.
Oh.
I got to check them with some hair to make sure they're cutting the tip.
I got them sharpened at Affordable Grooming Shears.
And he also, I don't know if you noticed on here, but did you notice where they were all scratched up right here?
No, I didn't notice that.
Yeah. That's sharpened.
Oh, no. The last time I got these sharpened was years ago. I did know that.
See that?
Yes. The guy who sharpened them was an older man. The guy who sharpened them showed me that. And he showed me he messed them up.
Well, he was using a flat hand, and so what I did was, I repolished them for you, Sam.
Oh, wow. So thanks.
I cut most of them out.
Thanks.
It wouldn't hurt to cut most of them.
Yeah. He was an older guy. Bother you to look at one more thing of yours? I'm sorry.
I got your plates in too, but I wanted to show you all that before you left.
So these are the ones that I dropped, and I just noticed that they're catching fur. Okay.
You need to spray this thing?
No. Last one, bud. Uh-huh. Not really. Not really for me. I use it sometimes. The shampoo's up there, but it's not often. Oh, yeah, it does catch a lot of hair. I mean, I get it completely. Because I would do the same thing. Like, do y'all need this?
Okay, so now that we're winding down to the end of Scout's groom, we are putting some finishing touches on him, giving him a little bow tie just so he can look all snazzy and prettied and dolled up for when his mom comes. But now we're going to take a flashback look to what he looked like when he first came in. This is what he looked like when he first came in. And now we're going to take a look at his after. This is his after. And he looks so handsome with his little tie. He looks so prestigious. I hope you guys love the groom. Make sure you guys smash that like button. Share this video. Drop a comment down below. Do all that fancy YouTube stuff. I love you guys. Train your dogs for grooming. Make sure you watch every video straight through. Watch those ads. Enjoy the videos. I'll catch you in the next one. Love you guys.